My name is Jackie Wenner, and I've been a fiber artist since retirement. Fiber involves fabric, and people with basket making are called fiber. But I'm always involved with fiber and mostly embellishment with beads and threads and bound objects and creativity like that. That's my thing.
I'm Jim Wenner, and I guess when you have somebody who really gets into art like my wife does, you eventually decide you want to try doing some things. So I like to just play around with all different kinds of things, nothing special. I've done some jewelry, I've done some painting, I've done some work with Tyvek. About anything I can think of, I come up with an idea and then decide that's what I'm going to do.
So, when and why did y'all start making art?
I've always done some stitching most of my life, but it was mostly with kits and people telling me what to do, and I really just got original after we retired from work, and I enjoyed it.
I'm pretty much the same. I just sort of come up with an idea and start working with something, or get an idea or something and then just work with that idea and see what happens. Sometimes it works and sometimes it's just thrown away.
We're both intuitive. We don't know what we're doing until we're over, until we're done.
What is your medium?
Mostly I make purses.
Oh, wow. That's pretty. So what's your muse?
Color, I think. That's the first thing I decide when I'm going to make something.
And I like to do mixed media, so it's just a combination of anything and everything that I can come up with. I've been working just recently with Tyvek and also with bounce sheets that have been painted and so forth, and I'm trying to work on a way to make it so it looks like it's waves almost, even though it's different colors and so forth.
What is your motivation?
Satisfying the creative appetite and earning a little money on the side for extra things.
I kind of feel the same way. It's just sort of I get an idea and I decide I want to do it and that's it. And then I don't know what happens to it. And sometimes it gets sold. Sometimes it's sitting in a pile and ready to be sold or whatever. But it just keeps on going.
Why are y'all here on the Outer Banks?
Well, we've been coming down here, believe it or not, for 25 years. But the first 15 of those years, we were just coming down and renting a house and so forth in the summer or whatever we could. And then in 2000, we bought a house, but we didn't move down here until 2005. So we've only been here, really living here, since 2005.
We both were retired, we decided. Let's take a chance. We love it for 2 weeks. Why not all year round?
And we should say that in the period between 2000 and 2005, we happened to come across a loft in our hometown that gave us lots of opportunities to experiment with art and a tremendous amount of room where we could do whatever we wanted to do and so forth. So that made a big difference when we moved down here to decide, let's convert the garage into living space and also add to that with the studio. I mean, everybody knows exactly
what I was talking about. Wow. Well, can we see your studio?
Sure. We also call this our storage bin. And recently, I've had a lady give me a whole bunch of fabric, so it's not organized yet. It's all in transition. But this is where I do most of my work. Right now I'm transferring images to fabric. Some work and some don't. It's going to be for Glenn Muir's place thing that he's doing. One of the shirts. All my threads are here. All my beads are here. Color coded. And fabrics and stuff. All that's cotton.
Well, and everything that I work on usually is out here at this table out here. So there are some things that I've been working on in the past. These are some of the things I kind of play around with. They're paintbrushes. They're sort of inspirational for people. And obviously, you can see I've done, since Jackie does purses, I obviously decided I really should do purses also. So I've done some purses. And then I'm playing around a lot with cereal boxes. And this was something that I did for Valentine's Day. Necklaces and bracelets and things.
felting. This is what you do first. You dye silk. Then you put it together with raw wool, like felting. But you're felting it to the silk, and it makes all kinds of crinkles and stuff. And
kind of like a scarf.
Yeah. I could make a purse out of it and just wear it. That's something new I've been doing. So we have fun.
Well, thank you all so much.
You're welcome.
Thank you.